Now, forget bad singing for a moment. Shall we hear some nice music?
Let's do that. Oh, it is, of course, the theme tune from Thomas the Tank Engine. The story's written by Reverend Wilbert Audrey, who made steam trains and children smile.
My father was the Reverend Wilbert Audrey, who wrote many of the Thomas the Tank Engine stories while he was vicar here in this parish of Emnoth in Norfolk in the 1950s.
Thomas is a tank engine who lives at a big station on the island of Sodor.
Well, little Thomas, chuckled Gordon as he passed. Now you know what hard work means, don't you?
Father loved all things to do with railways. The railway stories came around when my brother, Christopher, got measles, and Father, to entertain him, told stories. But there were only two rhymes that really interested Christopher, and one was down at the station early in the morning, see the little engines all in a row. And to make it a little bit more interesting, rather than just repeating it, Father ended up drawing engines, and he drew faces on them. But it was a sad one that interested Christopher, and he asked, "What's his name, Daddy?" So Father said off the top of his head, Edward. Hence, the first engine was not Thomas, but Edward, Edward the Blue Engine. The very first book that was published was The Three Railway Engines, which was in 1945. The first book was very well received and had to be reprinted several times because it was so successful. We moved here when I was 9. I lived here with my family, my brother Christopher, my sister Hilary. 13 of the 26 books were written here. It was wonderful living here as a child because it was so big, including three attics on the top floor, two of which my father commandeered for his model railway. You never played with a model railway. It was a passion, and that was it. Never playing trains. At tea time in the kitchen, Father used to bring in what he'd written and read aloud to us, because the stories were all written to be read aloud. The story, I think, that we perhaps had the most influence on was the one about Thomas and Bertie the bus having a race. All three of us were unhappy about the fairness of such a race because there seemed to be more hazards for one vehicle than another.
I'm going to win! I'm going to win!
So Father drew a sketch map to prove to us that each had the same number of hazards. The sketch map led Father to feel that the stories needed to be set in a place. And this led to, eventually, the introduction of the island of Sodor.
Welcome to the island of Sodor!
There was an episode where someone at school said, "Of course, you have no problem going somewhere on holiday. You can always go to the island of Sodor," because they believed that it was an actual place, which I think was rather lovely, actually. The small amount of money that came from the railway series was good to supplement a parson's stipend. It would be the sort of thing that would mean there was money perhaps to buy some new shoes or a winter coat, that kind of thing. And it was only, I suppose, 20 years later that any income had reached what the equivalent of his stipend was. And so he felt he was able to retire. He always wanted his epitaph to reflect his feelings about himself, if you like, what he gave. He would like it to say, he helped people see God in the ordinary things, everyday things of life, and made children laugh.
Well, his story certainly made me laugh, and my children too.